Live from Hastings College Gray Center Studio A, this is Bronco News Now. With anchors Lauren Sawyer and Jordan Brown. Weather with Abby Schmitz. And sports with Austin Druce. You're watching Bronco News Now.
Welcome to Bronco News Now. I'm Lauren Sawyer.
And I'm Jordan Brown.
On this episode of Bronco News Now, we take a look at what all the dogs are barking about. Check out the forecast for fall break, and we have everything you need to know about Bronco sports. But first, let's take a look at this week's Artist Lecture Series events. The topic of food was at the center of attention last week for the annual Artist Lecture Series Symposium. We have HC Media's team coverage to give you a taste of all the events. First, Food for Thought hosted a food packing event in the Student Union. Reporter Teal Timperley has the story.
On Wednesday, October 1st, the Artist Lecture Series Student Symposium held multiple events and speakers. One event included a community lunch packing.
Today, this morning, we packed lunches for Food for Thought. They go to local schools for students that and families that can't really help provide meals for themselves. They go towards that. They do that a lot during throughout the years to kind of help the community. And now that Food for Thought is in the Student Union, they can kind of help. The students can kind of be close by to help out anytime they want.
Food for Thought is a community donation-based food assistance program that provides bags of food to be sent home with elementary school children whose families qualify for the free and reduced lunch program. The idea being the children who do not have enough food to eat over the weekend will have more nourishment to keep them ready for the school week. To learn more about the lunch packing activities, contact any Food for Thought member. With HC Media, this is Teal Timperley.
Continuing our team coverage, Maddie Goodenkov caught up with two sculptors who work with, you guessed it, food, and who have earned recognition by Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Last Wednesday, students gathered at the center of the Hazel Rigg Student Union to celebrate food as a part of this year's Artist Lecture Series. This year, famous food sculptors Jim Vector and Marie Pelton showed students how food is not just for eating.
Food sculpture for many years, we're both through the fine arts train. That's how we got into this. We didn't get it through the food industry. We got into this through being artists. So that's what happened. And then we found a niche making sculptures out of food.
Vector and Pelton also showcased their talent by creating Thanksgiving-themed food sculptures throughout the day. They created a life-size replica of a turkey out of fruits and vegetables, and a gravy boat made out of chocolate. Anna Griggs, a member of the Student Symposium, organized the event.
For the students, it's just a time to learn about all different facets of one topic. So you explore all kinds of different parts of one specific topic. So food, for example, we learned about it as an art form, as a business, as part of our agriculture. So it's kind of just exploring every side of an issue.
Students were also granted the opportunity to interact directly by sampling some of the discarded food from the sculptures. It was a popular lecture with plenty of positive interaction from the students.
I think food sculpture is important because it shows that food is an art form also. So while it's something we consume and it's part of our business and agriculture, it's also an art. So you can take something that we consume and you can make it into something beautiful. So I think it's just a different perspective for students to learn about.
For HC Media, I'm Maddie Goodenkoff.
In our last look at the symposium, Maria Akers spoke on commodity prices and how agriculture impacts the community. Reporter Austin Rem has more.
Last Wednesday was a big day for ALS at Hastings College, with speakers doing presentations on food-based topics. Maria Akers, a representative from the Kansas City Federal Reserve Bank, spoke about the economics and agriculture, specifically the commodity prices and how they affect local farmers. With the price of corn so low, there is a record expectation for the yield of corn this year.
We are expecting pretty much a buffer crop this year. USDA has forecasted 171 bushels an acre. It is a record expectation for corn production this year.
Because agriculture plays such an important role in Nebraska's economy, anyone can profit off the success of farmers and their crop, including students.
Agriculture is obviously an economic engine for Nebraska, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to be a farmer to take advantage of that. There are a lot of spillover effects from the ag economy, a lot of manufacturing that's wrapped around ag, transportation, things like that. So it's really, you know, it broadens your opportunities to be connected to the industry, but, you know, maybe work in one of those kind of more support capacities.
For HC Media, I'm Austin Rim.
Well, that wraps up our Artist Lecture Series coverage for now. Let's head over to the Bronco News Now Weather Center to get a quick update with Abby Schmitz.
Good afternoon, Hastings College. I'm Abby Schmitz with your weather forecast for today. We have some great weather in store for us, as today will be a high of 63 degrees with partly cloudy skies and a small of 20% chance of rain after 3 p.m. We will also have 10 to 15 mile per hour winds from the northeast. Moving into the evening, we will have a low of 48 degrees with partly cloudy skies and again a small 20% chance of rain and 15 mile per hour winds from the northeast. I'll have your five-day forecast when we return later on in the show. Now back to Lauren and Jordan at the desk.
Thanks, Abby. The second annual Hastings Crop Hunger Walk will be on Sunday, October 19th. The Crop Hunger Walk raises money for local and global charities. 25% of the funds raised will help the Food for Thought program, and 75% will be donated to Church World Service, which sponsors charities worldwide that advocate for clean water, disaster, and hunger issues in third world countries. If you'd like to register for the walk or 5K option, contact Stephanie Schlosshauer at slots@charter.net.
Now for a topic that's a little more difficult to talk about, suicide. But Active Minds, the campus group that promotes mental health, started that dialogue through Suicide Prevention Awareness Week.
Life was worth living anymore. She didn't feel important, like anybody cared about her. She was being teased.
HC students shared their personal stories relating to suicide awareness. Active Minds members also provided resources and allowed students to share their stories.
We had a poster that we hung up that said every 40 seconds someone dies of suicide. That was kind of scary. And then I also learned that there's a lot of people out there who have been touched by suicide in some way or another. And so I think that it's an issue that we should actually address more.
Undiagnosed depression is the number one cause of suicide for college students. For help or more information regarding mental health, Hastings College has two counselors available with no appointment needed, or you can contact a member of Active Minds.
With flu season quickly approaching, I talked to Director of Campus Health Services, Beth Luttrell.
Summer is ending and winter is coming. You know what that means? Cold season as well. To help fight sicknesses, Beth Luttrell has tips from the health center across from Babcock.
Hand washing is super important. So anytime you touch a keyboard or follow someone into a building that's coughing and sneezing, you want to hit the hand sanitizer and wash your hands.
Fighting regular illnesses is easy, but to fight the flu is even harder. Flu shots are needed at the health center can provide across the street from Babcock.
Flu shots will start October 15 here at the health center. The Well Worth It committee on campus, the campus wellness committee, does an awesome job of subsidizing the flu shots. And students will pay $5 a shot. Faculty staff will pay $10.
With so much interaction on campus with other students, some students have been curious if the Ebola breakout has reached Hastings and how easy can it be to catch it.
There's already Ebola in Nebraska. Will it get to us or be part of the community? I don't think so, because again, you have to show symptoms and you have to have direct contact with bodily fluids.
I'm Jordan Brown. Stay healthy, Hastings.
So don't forget to stop by the health center for your $5 flu shot after October 15th.
When we return, we'll have more of your Hastings College news, and we'll check in with Abby Schmitz to get an update on the forecast. We'll also take a look at the no-kill animal shelter, Start Over Rover, and how you can volunteer and host your own events as part of Barktober Fest. To thank our sponsor, Sonic. You're watching Bronco News Now.
Coming. Please, everybody. Light check. 1, 2, 1, 2.
Everything looks good on our end.
And lights.
Come alive with the forest. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
You wouldn't let money just blow out of your house. So when your AC or heater is on, make sure the doors, windows, and fireplace flue are shut tight. If you're headed out, turn down the AC or lower the heat by 10 degrees. And always keep your water heater set at 120. A little bit of common sense goes a long way. Get more great tips at energysaver.gov.
Now, your Bronco News with Lauren Sawyer and Jordan Brown.
Welcome back to Bronco News Now.
If you love adorable animals with cute faces, then you should visit Start Over Rover, the local animal shelter. They accept volunteers and host events like Barktober Fest. Amanda Miller gets an inside look.
I'm Ann Halbert, and I am one of the lead volunteers here.
This is the third year that Start Over Rover, the local Hastings animal shelter, has hosted Barktober Fest. This year, the event is taking place on October 10th at the Eagles in downtown Hastings.
We just invite people to come, get together. We have raffle tickets we sell. We have a lot of raffle items. We have silent auction items. And this year, we're doing something a little different. We also have a band playing, and so we'll have some food. Start Over Rover is... It really is an amazing place. We are the only no-kill facility here in the Tri-Cities.
According to their website, Start Over Rover is a nonprofit organization that takes in strays, relinquished pets, abused and neglected pets, puppy mill cast-offs, and shelter transfers. They pay for the daily care required for these animals. If you're searching for a place to volunteer and get involved, then look no further.
There's lots of ways to get involved. We need people to do some computer things for us sometimes, some information, data information. We need people to help set up events. We need all kinds of different things, advertising, people to help make flyers. So there's a lot of different ways to get involved. It really is pretty amazing to see how a group of volunteers can make such a difference.
This is Amanda Miller, and you're watching Bronco News.
The Barktober festivities will be tomorrow in downtown Hastings from 7 p.m. to 12 a.m. If you'd like to do some volunteer work, their hours of operation are listed on their website at www.startoverrover.org, or you can call for more information.
The Hastings College Music Department had the first choir concert of the year last weekend. Reporter Jasmine Bruins has more.
The Hastings College Vocal Music Groups performed their annual Autumn Vespers concert on Sunday. The groups included the Women's and Men's Choir Ensembles and the Hastings College Choir. They are made up of students who have a variety of different majors, but all share a love for music. The students have been rehearsing for this concert for an hour a day since the beginning of the school year in August. A new element to this year's concert was a song that included all three choirs singing together.
This year we did a collaborative piece with all the choirs. Normally we end with our signature song, Beneath the Cross. But this year we did Let There Be Peace. My favorite part of the concert would have to be the collaborative part with all the choirs. It was just a beautiful rendition of that song, and just having all the choirs sing together, it was just a nice full sound for the Presbyterian Church.
The choirs will now begin rehearsing for their next concert in November in time for the holiday season. For HC Media, I'm Jaslyn Bruins.
The next holiday concert will be November 15th.
Well, the Theater Arts Department begins its first production of the school year with a 1920s classic, Six Characters in Search of an Author. Written by Luigi Pirandello, the Meta Theater play is full of unexpected events that is sure to have something for everyone. Professor Jim Fritzler says it's a play unlike any other and gives the audience things to ponder at the end of the play. The play is October 16th through the 18th at 8 p.m. and Sunday, October 19th at 2 p.m. with free admission for HC students. Students can pick up their tickets from the box office located in Scott Studio Theater. The box office remains open today and remains open Monday through Friday from noon to 5 p.m. Past performances, the box office will not be open before the production, so students must get their tickets ahead of time.
Like past performances, the box office will not be open before the production, so students must get their tickets ahead of time. Theater isn't the only art group happening this semester. 27 art students are taking a three-day trip to Chicago. Chicago art is popular due to its culture being centered on the affinitive and an energetic visual arts community. The students will visit museums, attend galleries, and they will attend the sculptures, objects, and functional art exhibition. Exhibition is a world premier art fair that features art centered by the country's top design universities. Art students, those who are involved, will leave with Tom Krieger November 5th at 6 a.m. It will be a great trip for them to be inspired and create new ideas. Have fun, guys.
Coming up, Austin Drews will update you on all your Bronco sports. But first, we'll check in with Abby Schmitz with your state highs and lows, as well as your five-day weather forecast.
Stay tuned. You're watching Bronco News Now.
Body language can tell you all sorts of things. Like someone is having a stroke. Know the sudden signs. Learn fast. Face drooping, arm weakness, speech difficulty. Time to call 911 and get them to a hospital immediately. Learn the body language and spot a stroke fast.
A boy born in Joplin, Missouri was fascinated by anything with wheels and a motor. The odds of him winning both the Daytona 500 and the Brickyard 400 in the same year? 1 in 195 million. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism? 1 in 68. I'm Jamie McMurray, and my niece has autism. Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs.
Now your Bronco weather with Abby Schmitz.
Welcome back, viewers. I'm Abby Schmitz with your weather forecast for today. As I said earlier, today will be a high of 63 degrees with partly sunny skies and a small 20% chance of showers after 3 p.m. We also have 10 to 15 mile per hour winds from the northeast. Moving into the evening, temperatures will drop to a low of 48 degrees with mostly clear skies and another 20% chance of showers, and also 15 mile per hour winds from the northeast again. Across the state, temperatures will range from the mid-60s to the high 60s in some parts of the area. Let's take a look. Up in Chadron, 63, down in Scotts Bluff, 69, Sydney, 68, up north in Valentine, 62, down in North Platte, 67, south in McCook, 68, here in Hastings, 63, up in Norfolk, 61, in our capital city at 64. Across the state, temperatures will drop to a low of 40 degrees in some parts of the area. Let's take a look at what tonight will look like. Up in Chadron, 40, down in Scotts Bluff and Sydney, 44, up in Valentine, 40 as well, down in North Platte, 43, McCook, 45, here in Hastings, 48, up in Norfolk, 41, and our capital city at 45 degrees. Let's take a look at the next 5 days to see what this weekend has in store for us. On Friday, we will have partly cloudy skies with a high of 55 degrees and a low of 43 degrees tomorrow night. Saturday, we will have mostly sunny skies with a high of 60 degrees, which is perfect for the Bronco football game with the kickoff starts at 1. And following that will be the men and women soccer matches at 5. And Saturday night will be a low of 44 degrees. Sunday, we will have mostly cloudy skies with a high of 62. Happy Columbus Day. On Monday, we will have mostly sunny skies. And while the students are gone away for fall break, we will have a high of 66 degrees and a low of 46. Finishing off the week, Tuesday will be sunny skies with a high of 67 and a low of 48 degrees. That's the look at your five-day forecast. Now let's send it back to Lauren and Jordan at the desk.
Thanks, Abby. After the break, Austin Drews will update us on how the newest head soccer coach on campus has made an impact with his team so far this season. $50. We'd like to thank our proud sponsor, Sonic. Stay tuned. You're watching Bronco News Now.
What's going on?
I'm leaving.
Why? What did I do?
Not enough. You constantly ignore me. You barely eat anything healthy. You're half as active as you used to be. The pressure is just too much. I quit.
Okay, I get it. I'll do better. Just please, don't leave.
Okay. But remember, if I go, you go.
Listen to your heart. Don't let it quit on you. Uncontrolled high blood pressure could lead to stroke, heart attack, or death. Get yours to a healthy range before it's too late.
Now, your Bronco Sports with Austin Drews.
Welcome back, folks. I'm Austin Drews with your sports. We have a full lineup of Bronco info to cover today, so let's get started, shall we? The men's soccer team took on Nebraska Wesleyan Tuesday night and for the first time since 2007 gave up a goal to the Prairie Wolves. Reporter Rachel Garn has more.
The Hastings College men's soccer team is currently sitting at number 16 in the latest NAIA coaches poll, and the Broncos would face Nebraska Wesleyan, a team that hadn't scored on the Broncos since 2007. After Shane Davidson headed the ball to put Hastings up 1-0, Nebraska Wesleyan snapped their scoreless drought against the Broncos as Chris Larson lobbed the ball past Alex Geyer to tie things up before halftime. The Broncos came alive in the second half with goals from Julius Goathart, Jake Ramsey, and Damian Austin to take a 4-1 victory. Hastings College moves to 8-2-2 overall and 4-0-1 in the GPAC. The Broncos will next face Dort College on.
Broncos will next take on Dort College this Saturday, October 11th at 7:15 p.m. over at Lloyd Wilson Field. Women's soccer coach, the head soccer coach, Chris Clements, is halfway through his first season at Hastings College, and the team is earning more than just goals. Reporter Mackenzie Weedle gives us the story.
The Hastings College women's soccer team has seen great success this season under first-season head coach Chris Clements. Senior forward Kelsey Nealon and sophomore forward Taylor Geis both lead the team in scoring with 9 goals apiece. Geis earned GPAC Offensive Player of the Week after scoring a hat trick against Midland.
I just think it's having goal scorers out there. You know, we have quite a few goal scorers out there. We played Midland on Wednesday. Nealon got a goal and Geis got 3 goals. And tonight Geis got another goal and then Bennett got a goal. So really it's just the ability to have goals come from multiple people is really the important thing.
Goalkeeper Mallory Taylor has made 50 saves on the season, earning GPAC Defensive Player of the Week for 2 weeks in a row, not giving up a goal in the last 4 games.
Yeah, you know, Mal's fast off her line. That really helped her tonight coming out and kind of cutting off some opportunities before they even arise. So she's just continuing building and getting good saves and getting good performances game after game.
The Broncos are currently on a 9-game winning streak for the first time since 2011, when the team had 17 consecutive wins before losing in the second round of the national tournament. Even though the team earned a win on Tuesday, Clemens sees room for improvement looking into the future.
Really, we just got to pick up our level of play. We've got to play faster, we've got to be more aggressive, and we've just got to be able to control the game from the start to the finish. I think that's going to be our keys to Saturday.
For HC Media, I'm Mackenzie Weedle.
Bronco fans, you can catch Clements and the Broncos in action as they continue their winning streak this week against Dort College at 5 p.m. at Lloyd Wilson Field. The Bronco volleyball team had an incredible win last night against the number 8-ranked Midland University Warriors. Reporter Russ Heitman sets us up with some highlights.
Fans were in for a treat Wednesday night as the Hastings College volleyball team took the 8th-ranked Midland Warriors to 5 sets before coming out with the win at Lynn Farrell Arena, winning 3-2. Midland was able to jump out early in the first set, taking a commanding lead. They were able to ride this early momentum and win the first set 25-18. Head coach Matt Buttermore turned things around for the Broncos, though, in sets 2 and 3, winning handily 25-20 and 25-18.
The fourth set was a back-and-forth affair, with the Broncos and Warriors trading blows before Midland was able to win the set by a narrow margin, 25-23. However, the final set belonged to the Broncos and sophomore middle hitter Logan Drupal, who took over the game with a multitude of solid spikes and strong blocks at the net. It came down to the final plays of the game before Drupal was able to hammer home the winning spike. Hastings' next play is at home against Concordia University. The game will be a pink out in support of breast cancer awareness. For HC Media, this has been Russell Heitman.
The Broncos look to carry their momentum to Nebraska Wesleyan at 5 p.m. this Saturday. As the semester nears its halfway mark, anyone feeling the need to blow off some steam should check out the Hastings Shooting Club. The team is a fun way to meet new people and learn more about guns and gun safety. Reporter Tyler Schuster has more.
The Hastings College shooting team has excelled thus far this season. The Broncos have competed in two different competitions, resulting in a fourth place finish in the Fort Hays State University shooting tournament and a fifth place finish in the Shocker Fall Classic in Wichita, Kansas.
Well, the Hastings College Shooting Club actually has two different areas that we're trying to work with. Number one, on Thursday nights, we're open to all of the Hastings College students to come out and shoot. And what we're trying to accomplish with the Thursday night group is to dispel some of the myths or rumors about guns and gun safety.
The Hastings College shooting team practices two nights out of the week. Monday nights are for the serious shooters looking to possibly earn scholarships and compete in competitions, while Thursday nights are open to all Hastings College students looking to learn more about shooting or gun safety.
Practice is about having fun. It's about playing different games, just introducing people to guns. So Thursday is a lot less structured.
Coach Hergett is happy with how the team has performed so far.
And the kids are doing well. There's a couple freshmen that have come in and that are really helping us. I'm very, very proud of what the kids have accomplished.
Thanks, Tyler. For more info on the HC shooting team, contact head coach Ron Hergett. Despite peak interest of particular intramurals in the spring, attendance for some events have been sparse at best. Reporter Sam Bennett gives us the story.
When the schedule for this year's intramurals was released at the beginning of the school year, one of the new sports being organized was softball. However, despite support during the spring semester, the participation was less than adequate.
Last semester, we had gotten 3 emails about having a co-ed softball tournament and a Quidditch tournament. So we decided to schedule them, one for this semester, one for second semester. And we had that 2 weeks ago. And we had one team sign up, and that was it.
This field, adjacent to the YMCA, was to be the site of the one-day softball tournament. However, no games were played. The lack of attendance is a trend that Patatl has noticed in other intramural sports this semester.
Like, in the week before that, we had the Ultimate Frisbee tournament, and I think we had 6 teams sign up, and we had 3 people show up, and they weren't even on the same team.
Another sport that's been added is Quidditch, a game based on the sport in the Harry Potter series. Patatl says that he expects participation in this to be a bit better than in softball.
Well, it's an unusual game, so I feel like some more people will be interested in it instead of softball, because a lot of people think that watching softball and playing softball is kind of boring. So I feel that they'd be more interested, since it's a unique game and they've never played it before.
For HC Media, this is Sam Bennett reporting.
Thank you, Sam. We hope to see a turnaround for future intramurals. Unfortunately, ladies and gents, that is all we have for sports this week. Stay tuned. You're watching Bronco News Now.
That's all we have for this episode. We won't have a show next week due to fall break, but tune in 2 weeks from now for more news, weather, and sports on Bronco News Now.
Thanks for tuning in to Bronco News Now. Remember, you can relive all the BNN fun by watching full episodes and reading more stories online at acmediaonline.org. Have a safe and fun fall break from us at BNN.